What's up, guys? We are here with the Thorn versus Nador. Let me just see if anyone wants to join. What I see is, what I saw in the chat is, like, someone said Nador said the Thorn said Venusaur has no good matchups, and now he brought a Venusaur, which is, like, funny to me. Let me close my Discord, it's unnecessary. Don't need that at the moment. So let me actually look at the teams. Haven't gotten the opportunity. Brings a Doggy. Hopefully Doggy gets banned soon. Even though I should have tested Arena Trap instead of Doggy, but that's for another time to discuss. Would he be Ash or Proin? It seems he's Ash, and he gets a freeze. So if the Skeldy doesn't have, Scald, if it's like Scarf Skeldy with Surf and Hydro Pump, this is really annoying, but I assume he's the Breakneck Blitz, because the Landorus would make sense to be Rocks. It could still be Rocks Z move, but yeah, he has Scald, so he's probably the Breakneck Blitz one. Let me just see. Yeah, let me just call these people. Where's the call? So the Clef ate that up. The Clef ate that for breakfast. It's pretty sure it's Breakneck Blitz, like.
Did you record the game that just went on?
Yeah. But you're super low. So he's Rocks Clef. Yeah, that's his only potential rocker besides the Ducky.
Yo, did the game already start?
Yeah, it's at turn 4. The Thorn versus Nidor. Nidor, however you pronounce him.
So weird.
So I mean, he's probably just getting rocks.
The Thorn brought Stall last time, didn't he?
Yeah, he did. And he had pursued Doggy last time to, like, trap Marowak.
What is this Mega Venusaur Clefable?
Fat balance with a Doggy and the Greninja.
He has a Reuniclus, which is pretty cool.
I like Reuni. Like, yeah, Abia blew me away with Reuni on the suspect ladder.
Reuni is really underrated. Oh, he throws the Keldeo?
Wait, yo, what? Which turn? Oh yeah, he thought he had Scald.
But the burn on the Tangrowth is pretty...
Yeah, it is annoying.
Thorn plays for the Scooters, right?
Yeah. Scooters versus Raiders.
Thorn's this is for Thorn's first SPL, but he's been pretty solid so far in both ORS and Sun Moon.
So what's the pivot here? He just sacks it. I thought he'd pivot out into.
He didn't have a switch in, to be honest.
Couldn't he have gone Zygarde?
But
it depends on the set.
Leech. Yeah, it's a leash and then fucking Clefable switches in all day. You think this is Bandit? You've seen Bandit like brought three games in
everywhere.
A row. Yeah, it's like people have really caught onto that set.
It's Bandit. It's a threat.
I don't think it's the subset.
Leech Seed is not here. Leech Seed is never the play here.
In comes the most broken one of them all. Like, what does he even do if it's banned? If Venusaur gets blown away, it's not Megahead.
Like, despite Ban being an amazing set, I feel like Sub might just... Nah, Sub loses to Clefable. So he's thinking really hard here. He just goes for Leech.
Is that Bandit?
That's Bandit. I think that's Bandit.
Is it Fist Dev Stealer?
Nah, he's Spit Dev Celesteela because he got the Spit Dev boost.
That's really Bandit that and nothing.
Yeah,
that's like Jolly, right?
No, a Bandit runs Adamant. Like Bandit.
Yeah, but that's not bad Adamant, no way. Celesteela just beats this, like. I mean, now it does more because it's grounded, but actually, yeah, this kills. Yeah, never mind.
I mean, he's not. I don't see him breaking.
He's not staying in. Yeah, his entire team is like kind of annoyed by Celesteela. Holy shit! Why'd he go for this?
Hard Vino.
So I think Clef. I guess we can.
This might be a roll.
That good anyways. The only thing Clef is good against is Keldeo.
Keldeo kills it with Brentnik Blitz at plus one anyway.
Is Keldeo Z-move or is it Scarf?
It's Scald, so I assume it's Z-move.
Doesn't have a Scarfer.
Maybe he has Bullet Punch plus E-Speed maybe.
Yeah, I guess that works.
And maybe Shift Gear Magearna or Trick Room for speed control.
True.
Reuniclus kind of checks this. Like, if he doesn't get a mesh boost.
You think he's hard Thunder Punching here? I think he's just going to the fucking blob.
He's mashing.
He's just going to a Reuni. Like, he shouldn't go Steela, because he's Spadef and this thing might be carrying Thunder Punch. And if he has Thunder Punch, he's 100% going for it here. Real nigga goes for HP Fire. Real nigga HP Fire is here.
Oh, Venusaur. I was about to say. HP Fire macros, what?
Yeah, real nigga HP Fire is with Venusaur. Real nigga stays in it.
You won't do it.
Why is he Helmet Tang on that team?
Yeah, it's not weak to Metagross. It can be played around. No, because his Nidor's Metagross is Hammer Arm. Because look at how annoying Ferrothorn is.
I mean, maybe he's HP Fire Magearna.
So it makes sense for him to be
HP Fire Tang.
Lucky Helmet.
Actually, he has to be HP Ice for Zygarde, probably. On the tank.
The best case scenario for Nidor here is if the Thorn just times out. Nope.
Sacks the Clef.
Sacks the Clef. Yeah, I guess that's an alright play, because Clef isn't doing anything anyways. Misses a Meteor Mash, so he's probably going...
Yeah, it doesn't matter.
I think he's just staying in. He's going for the T-Wave. T-Wave, just do it. Do it.
Think he might have knockoff on this, or...
T-Wave is the play here, 100%. Yeah. No. You think this is Ash?
It is Ash, it's already revealed.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
It's Ice Beam, it's probably not U-turn then.
Yeah, Some of them run Ice Beam for Zygarde.
You think he's gonna pump on Magearna?
Nah, I think he's pulsing. He has no reason to make an aggressive play like that.
Yeah, he's pumping. Bob.
Wait.
So if it's not Scarf Keldeo, it's gone.
Pump didn't kill.
I mean, Son is an aggressive play. I don't know. He plays like me. He just says, nah, I don't care. I click that button.
He lost nothing by going for Dark Pulse. He has safe switch-ins to Magearna.
Wait, you said Pump didn't kill? Pump kills, it's Specs. Would've killed Metagross. Why is it not Specs?
Are you sure it kills? Are you sure
Specs? Oh, it's not in the Ash form, never mind.
That is sick.
Yeah.
For some reason I thought it was in his Super F form already.
Yeah, Super
Saiyan. Yeah, so he's not Scarf Keldeo. Oh, he predicted a death switch.
Good play by Nidor, making that switch.
Of course, yeah, Metagross stays broken. Ah, nice Z-move.
A Z-Shadow Ball?
Yeah, Z-Shadow Ball. How does that not kill? Because it's dong.
Because Metagross is busted.
That's an interesting tag. Might have to put Reuni in the thumbnail for that.
Nah, Reuni getting young thumbnail.
I mean...
That did nothing.
Yeah, that's like not special attack invested, I assume.
Yeah, because it's not special attack invested, yeah.
Metagross doesn't have that good of, like, the best spit diff.
Wait, Whitey sack? I guess he didn't. Yeah, sacking Doggy was alright.
So now he can just click Dark Bolts?
He might actually be special attack invested, though. You think it's Trick Room Reuni or you think it's Calm Mind?
Nah, because that mash literally did nothing.
Probably Shadow Ball, Psy Shock, Calm, and Recover.
Yeah, he's
Fizz Def. Yeah, he's Fizz Def from how he took the Meteor Mash.
He's just Dark Pulsing here.
Yeah.
Or if he's real, he goes right.
We're still waiting for the real game, Ricardo vs. PDC.
Oh yeah, Ricardo vs. PDC, that game's gonna be fucking
I don't care
hot.
About the other ones.
Yeah, that's like, fuck this week, dude. Like, Ricardo vs. PDC is the only game I've been waiting for the entire week. But does that game even matter or?
Cryonicles can make it 6-6. They're on the back. They have to win every game.
Yeah.
And they subbed in NJNP over like.
Yeah, NJNP is playing doubles
over
you, right?
Over Kalko, yeah, subbed
in. If this is Steelium Z Trick Room, couldn't it win?
Couldn't it win? Yeah.
It's Trick Room or Shift Gear.
If it's T-Bolt, it might actually just win.
I mean, I know it's
how not. Healthy is the Vina? Let me see. So Vina's really healthy.
Dude, if this is Trick Room, Electrium Z, it just wins.
It's not beating the Vina, so how?
No, Steelium. Shit.
Flash Cannon does a shit ton to Venusaur. It would KO.
Doesn't it do like 35 or 40?
No, dude. Like, yeah, if it's Spit Death, I guess.
Oh, it's probably Assault Vest. It could still be Trick Room with Volt Switch. I've seen that set.
No. Trick Room, Volt Switch, Trick Room is not a thing.
I've seen that set. Darius runs that.
So that didn't run Darius.
If I'm not mistaken. With leftovers, but Death Trick Room, Volt Switch, Flurrican, and what was the last move? I forgot.
So he just sacks.
Celestia,
he sacks Ryu.
Probably.
No, Celestial is still good for.
So I see sacks Ryu at 24 after rocks.
Yeah, but it can come in protecting elite team.
Ryuniclus can like check the Keldeo, kind of, not really.
Yeah, but
Venusaur has Venusaur too.
Yeah, so just sack Ryuni. Sacking Steela wouldn't be the play in my opinion, because it's good for Lando.
Is it already revealed that the Lando is defensive without SD? Because some Lando run rocks with SD.
Yeah, if he's offensive Lando, it could be an issue.
He needs like more damage on the Magearna to win with Greninja. And they have to be careful about E-Speed.
But this game is still winnable by both players.
Like, this is a bit more interesting than the Steve Angelo game, but it's still not that interesting.
No, like, it's still, like, both players have a good shot at winning, yeah. Depending on what sets their Pokemon are.
I mean, He was Rocky Helmet on Tangrowth, so it's pretty much confirmed that he's Assault Vest on Magearna then. Because, like, that makes the most sense to me if he's not AV Tangrowth.
Trick Room Magearna just won.
Like, I thought that at first, but I don't think he could afford to be that set. Unless he's Spadef Trick Room, the Darius special. That boy made like some really cool team with Bandit Coco. I loaded that shit up earlier. Just kept winning. Oh, he's timing out soon.
Like, Nidor's WinCon is coming through, which is.
Dude, I'm 29 hours away. Make you move. I'm not trying to stay up all night. It's 9 p.m.
Hurry
here.
Up. Oh.
It's gonna die. Yeah, so you met the play that you suggested.
Yeah.
And useless crit. I'm really not sure if that's That Zygarde looks so weak, that's not adamant.
Yeah, now he goes in a ninja, and pumps. If I'm Nidor, I just stay in and go for the miss.
Watch this be off played and go for E-speed here.
Actually, no, that's not the play. Sacking Lando is the play. The real nigga play is going for the miss, but the sensible play is sacking Lando.
It's not Earthblade, but it would be really cool to see him go for E-speed here.
E-speed? Earthblade E-speed?
I don't think that's he is that. Set. I'm just like joking around. Yeah.
Dude, Earthblade E-speed is a cool idea.
Sack Keldeo or something else?
Doesn't
sack
too.
Yeah, sack Keldeo. Keldeo does nothing. No, Keldeo checks Greninja. Yeah, no, sack. Fuck. The play here is just sack Lando.
Doesn't Keldeo just die to Greninja? Because it's like... it's
sack Lando, go Magearna and Bolt.
Doesn't Magearna take two?
It doesn't take two Hydras. But
it can't come in again.
Actually, it might take two. Yeah, it probably does like 40-ish. Yeah, it does take two.
Because this Zygarde is his win con, right?
No, Magearna doesn't even take two, wow.
Really not?
It does 49 min.
I thought it does like 44 to 49.
He needs a Zygarde to win. It still depends. I don't know if he's offensive Lando or not.
Yeah, I think that was fine. Kali wasn't doing much.
Which leads me to believe he's probably offensive Landorus.
Still think he's the move Kalio. Didn't get revealed. So he's vault switching here.
Oh yeah,
unless he has Trick Room, maybe he's going for Trick Room if he has it, but he probably doesn't have it. Because he could
if he was non spark Keldeo, sacking Keldeo was the play.
He could have gone for Trick Room earlier if he had it, so that's probably not the case then. Yeah,
he's just vault switching into Zygarde. The Thorn wins this because he has more sacks. Actually, the play here is the Flash Cannon on the Venusaur.
They have like the same amount of sex.
But he has Greninja in. Like I said, the play was the Flash Cannon on the Mega Venusaur.
Well, not if he's
if he's Supersonic Sky Strike.
He's like his chance. Yeah.
I mean, doesn't SD into Continental Crush kill this anyway?
It does a ton.
But he risks him going hard, Ninja.
No one goes Heart Ninja. Actually, the Sauna is insane, he might. I didn't mean that in a negative way, like I like his aggressive plays. they call him Dog Ridge. We stay up 40 Z-Fly. Hours for SBL.
Z-Fly might just win Nidor the game here.
I mean, regardless, it's a choke for Thorn to stay in, because Celesteela doesn't do anything.
I mean, he could be offensive Landorus since he has Tangrowth to Chapman.
If this isn't Z-Fly Landorus, I would have Flash Cannon the Celesteela.
Which is why I think it's Z-Fly.
Actually, I was expecting Z-Move Keldeo the entire time. There it is. Gone.
It's Flash Cannon the... what's its face, yeah. So yeah, Nidor wins this.
Landorus, like, if you get a kill with a Z-Move, you should always get an attack boost like Magearna does.
I don't understand why he sacked the thing. He should have sacked Celesteela.
Yeah. Like Z-moves are already broken, like, but that would be like a nice boost if you like get the plus one if you get a kill with a Z-move. To make them even more broken so we can ban them.
he just goes Magearna here. He just goes Magearna. Like he wins with banded A speed anyways, he just goes Magearna and Volt Switches. Nothing the Thorn can do.
Dang, this is like... the Raiders are just unstoppable. You cannot do anything.
Yeah.
Like, this week is close. Last week was close too. But the weeks before, they were dominating.
Sacking the Venu was kind of a dumb play.
I expected Z-Move Keldeo at first, but the more I thought about it, it makes sense because the defensive Tangrowth is like already there to check physical attacker, so he doesn't need a defensive Lando.
Yeah. He just Volt Switches here, sacks the Lando. If the Thorn somehow pulls this out.
He needs like a double tact. Some shit. Is he lead seating here?
Yeah, he's 100% lead seating here.
No, obviously, Volt Switch was obvious, yeah.
Why damn, if the Celesteela somehow pulls this through.
Wait, Landorus doesn't beat this. What?
Real nigga lead seeds again. Real nigga lead seeds again.
What can Landorus even do to touch this?
He can't. He's forced to switch again.
I'm not sure about that
play. And the Thorns placed a 100% lead seed again. Here.
Nice and aggressive.
Dude, Celesteela is.
Reveal leftovers, protect lead sheet, flamethrower, atomize.
If the Thorn somehow pulls this out, he's officially the GOAT.
Actually, atomize doesn't help him because he only has flamethrower to hit the Zygarde then. If he is dead set for no reason. He's obviously heavy slam in the last slot. Ah, nice play. You think he's gonna expect Nidorah double and not protecting?
Yeah.
Like, you think he's leech seeding again? He made that aggressive play, wow. Yeah, that was like a bit...
He's just trying to sack mag.
I'm pretty sure he's leech seeding again here.
Just
protect?
Volt switch would be a misplay here. Just sacking Magearna is the smartest play. And then going Zygarde, Thousand Arrowing, and going from there.
Shaxx said Greninja wins, but it dies to E-Speed.
Yeah.
But I guess if as long as you have the Steela around, you can like keep the E-Speed thing in check.
He said Shuriken Freestyle. I don't know if he's trolling. He's probably just trolling. he's trolling.
Okay. Yeah, you can't just heavy slam, or is Magearna fast because Celesteela runs minus speed edge?
Dude.
Oh, Magearna is fast.
Real nigga plays go Greninja. Go, if the Thorn goes Greninja here on the HP fire. And I probably died, didn't it, after rocks? Maybe. Hard Zygarde. Do
Ninja
it.
Barely lives probably HP fire, but then he. If he goes Ninja on HP fire, he cannot switch out anymore because he would
hard
be.
Hard Zygarde on the protect. Need or do it.
He would be in range to die from rocks.
Yeah, he didn't do it. Yeah, he wins. So so the play here is to go for Thousand Arrows and then switch out to Lando. Or he doesn't even have to switch out to Lando. So, yeah, he just stays in.
The door's coming back. He lost last week was a Zamrock.
Yeah, switching out to Lando was.
Actually, that was the song that Zamrock beat last week. I don't remember.
He needs like a.
Actually, the Son brought stall last week, right?
He needs
if
a triple tech.
If he gets the double tech, he wins.
Does he need a double tech or a triple tech?
Nah, he just needs one tech, a double, and then he can switch out, right?
Yeah, but then.
Wait.
Yeah, he misplayed. Oh no, he didn't. He did the smart. Hold on.
Yeah, he might win.
So he needs a double protect.
You think he's gonna like?
No.
He's not gonna lead seed again.
Nidor has to stay in.
Okay.
Nidor has to stay in.
Yeah, that makes sense. Because if he switches, he gets way too healthy again.
Come on, no hacks.
Wait, 30%? Does this kill? This doesn't kill.
Yeah, but then the Lando can EQ afterwards. It's Smackdown.
Oh.
No hacks, Pokemon. Come on.
No hacks.
Finally, no hex.
And he gets a roll too. Who said got lucky on Ford? Where did he get lucky? Which turn? I don't remember.
That game was intense as fuck towards the end.
Blunder, his team was cool at least.
Nah, dude. That game got intense as hell.
Let me see. Like, I'm pretty sure the Raiders are up 5-4 now. So we're still waiting on the GOAT, Ricardo.
Ricardo.
There should be like Seattle playing soon, but you don't really care about that. I might record that. But if Ricardo like gets online, I'm clicking X on the other game. Oh, Porsche versus Adam is in like 3 hours. Good God, that's 2 a.m. my time. Oh yeah, Cicada versus G-Mix should be, I don't know when it is. It says after 2, but it's already 3 EST if I'm not mistaken. Thank you guys for watching anyways. There's gonna be like 3 or 4 more games probably that I'm gonna cover. So stay tuned for that and peace out. Thanks to my guests too.